back and our funny bonus pickled every single week as Aileen Jackie Joyner Kersee does so. She's so good at it. ABC's sci-fi comedy, The Neighbors, is what we're talking about. And we're sitting down with Tokes Ulagundaye.
You got all the letters in there.
I got them all in there.
Yes. And the vowels?
Yeah. All, yes. Yeah. All, everything's in there. So, you know.
It's okay. You play Jackie Joyner Kersee. Have you ever met her?
I've not.
No?
No. I've apparently she wants nothing to do with me. No, I've not. I've not. No, I would love to have her.
Is
on
there
the
anything
show.
About her that you try to put in your character? Because it's just, I mean, this alien doesn't.
Well, she's black, so yeah. I did this.
You did that?
But, yeah.
For that? Wow, that is method. Yeah.
Originally Asian.
That is really Asian. Method.
Yeah.
And you did the height as well. That's
yeah.
crazy. Wow.
Yeah. Yeah, that was painful, but.
So, but for anyone who hasn't seen the show, which I doubt, but to explain like how you ended up being having the name anyway.
Well, a bunch of aliens who moved to New Jersey, of course, and take over
yeah,
a golfing community, of course, and decide in order to blend in, they need to take the names of the most elite physical specimens, being sports stars. Best way to fit in.
The and who we have a Larry Bird on the show
we
who's
do.
Not the main Larry Bird.
No, no,
I'm not as tall as he is. Yeah.
No, no, we did have, and I'm not going to say his name, but we did have a guest star on who came on because he'd never watched the show and he thought it was the real Larry Bird.
Oh, he did? Oh my gosh,
really?
I love that.
Yes, he did, and he found out during his wardrobe fitting that that wasn't going to happen.
Oh,
as they are into this. The whole premise is that they've come here to Earth, and they are sampling us.
Well, what it is that
what?
I
okay, okay.
Soylent Green.
Yes, right. Yes.
People. Their planet is suffering weather-wise. Sound familiar?
Well, so are we.
So they're not. You know, they didn't do very good research.
No, okay.
These aliens clearly
they came to another
yeah.
problem. Okay.
Yeah. So they come and they have been here for 10 years when the show starts. So yeah.
Well, we're gonna share a little bit. Of this with the audience. Does this need setting up? No? Let's
no.
take a look.
Okay.
Let's jump right into the alien world.
Buenas noches, Weavers.
Hey, guys, we're actually in the middle of dinner right now.
I'm doing terrible. Thanks for asking.
I just pulled a double shift at Salsa Castle. It was hella loco.
And I'm pretty much single-handedly keeping the coffee shop afloat. Working in the food industry is nothing like two guys, a girl, and a piece of bliss.
If only there was something that existed to help us relax.
Yes. Socially acceptable opportunity to get away from it all for, say, 1 to 2 weeks a year with the understanding that you then return to work refreshed and recharged, thus actually improving productivity.
Okay, well, what you guys are describing is called a vacation. And it just so happens that this family is going to be going on one.
We are?
Yeah. The kids deserve to know their grandma. And we all deserve a little R&R.
Yeah!
Wait, why are you guys cheering?
Because we're coming, too.
No. No, you're not going to go.
You know
with...
what? That might not be such a bad idea. The more bodies, the less time I have to spend alone with my mom and her new special friend. So what do you say, guys? You want to be our alien buffers?
We'd be honored.
No, you moved next door to them and then like they found out almost immediately. But they're in a whole neighborhood full of aliens.
Well, they moved next door to us because one of the couples of aliens go back to Zabrod because they had it with Earth and they get a good price on the house. So
they got a good price on the
that
house.
It looks like such a fun yeah, set show. To work on.
It really is.
When you look at it, do you have a hijinks on it or is it all work, work, work?
I mean, everyone's pretty respectful of the fact that we're working long days and, you know, yeah. have to focus. But we do have a few. We had Rosalind Chow, who is Simon Templeman, who plays Larry Bird's actual wife, on the show. She'll be in upcoming episodes. And we have an episode where we have a cutout of Larry Bird in just a Speedo. And the cutout traveled all over the place and ended up in... there it is.
Wow.
Ended up in, must be so proud.
Oh, yeah. And ended up in her trailer. And she was like, no, get it out, get it out. And then later on, she was like, there are moles on his body that I didn't notice. He has to go in and get them checked. Yeah.
Wow, I can't...
Wow, that's like Where's Waldo?
I know.
You just find him, you place him in the parking
lot. He's very happy
lot.
About it.
You'd hate to come across that in a parking lot at night and be like, what's the man with the Speedo doing?
Listen, some people would like that. Don't judge.
Yeah. Don't get any ideas. No ideas.
I think it would be great. We'd have a big cut out of you here. Speedo.
So, okay. Where were you born and raised?
I was born in Nigeria, raised in Nigeria. my name Tokes is indicative of not being born and raised in Nigeria, so unfortunately I have to go through the whole story with Nigerians who get very hostile about it sometimes. But my mum is Norwegian, which is why I have the name Tokes.
So do you tend to favor one side more than
the other? No, I'm very, very proud of being Nigerian, and I very much feel like a Viking as well. So, my mum is a trip, and she's pretty much my favorite person on the planet. So,
when did you come from Nigeria here to the States, or were you born here?
No, I was born in Nigeria, raised in Nigeria. Right. We lived in England when I was 3 and 4, and then we moved back to Nigeria, went to the American school there for elementary school, and then I went to boarding school in England.
Okay, and how old? Because I know that at a very young age, I mean, you decided that you were going to, because we love food around here, and we like to think that we're very healthy and we give good advice. And you became a vegetarian at a very young age.
Yeah, not a full vegetarian. I still ate poultry and fish, but I couldn't do mammals anymore because we would get, for like Christmas, we would get like live animals as gifts. Oh. And I would bond with the animal and then I would eat the animal.
Oh no, that must have been terrible.
And that wasn't really my deal, so I sort of gave it up, and everyone thought I was insane at the time. Being Norwegian and Nigerian, everyone eats meat, you know.
Right. Sure.
You should have seen my Norwegian family when I gave up dairy. My grandmother's still like, what? She's not like, getting it.
Did you go back there at all for visits?
Or I've not been in about 5-6 years. Uh-huh. Yeah, because I've just been
too busy.
Yeah, but next year is my dad's 70th, so we must all needs be there for that.
Oh, yes. Well,
are you going to be working on anything during your hiatus?
I mean, I work on little things here and there that are my own deal. I have a web series that's coming out next month.
What is it?
It's called Callbacks, and it's about a casting office.
Oh, cool.
And I play the polar opposite of JJK. My character MJ is really, she's nasty.
Oh.
She's not nice.
Come back.
Yes.
And then we'll go in the kitchen and we'll make some vegetarian.
Yes. Dish. Let's do something.
Okay. Yes.
Yes.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
So nice to have
fantastic.
You.
Thank you.
Check out Tokes on The Neighbors Fridays, 8:30, 7:30 Central on ABC. You can follow her on Twitter at Tokes Olagundaye.
Yes.
Did I get it right?
Yes.
Gundaye. I said it right the first time and then I screwed up the second.